Hello, good evening, everybody. Welcome to the first talk in the Illuminating Talk series. Today we have two very special guests, both of them from very different careers, but the one thing they share is they're both graduates of ISO Bhopal. The first guest for today is Miss Riya Modi. She graduated from ISO Bhopal with a BSMS in chemistry in 2018. She secured an AIR 4 in the GATE chemistry exam 2018, AIR 34 in CSIR NET 2017, and AIR 94 in CSIR NET 2016 in the chemical sciences stream. She's done several summer internships at ISC Bangalore and NCL Pune, and she has worked with Professor Saptarshi Mukherjee for her master's thesis on the topic spectroscopic probing of refolding of an unfolded protein through the formation of a mixed micelle. Currently, she's working as an executive officer chemist in the Oil and Natural Gas Corporation, which is the ONGC, and is posted at Mumbai. Our second alumni for today is Flight Lieutenant Abhay Singh Chandel. He was from the first graduating batch of ISR, which is batch 2013. Graduated in 2013. He's done his BSMS in mathematics and is currently an officer in the Indian Air Force. So we thank you both for attending. Abhijit sir, do you want to say something or should we proceed?
Yeah, so I would like to welcome both of you. It's a great pleasure, Abhay and Ria, to have you here. It's a great honor for us that you could find the time and interact with our current batch of students. So the way you have developed your career, that will be helpful for all the current students. So I welcome you once again, and we'll be in touch. And thank you very much. So, Sakshi, you can start the proceedings.
Yes, sir, sure. So we'd like to start with basically with some general questions. So we would start with a question for both of y'all. Is that when you finished your school days, was joining ISER always in your mind? Like, had you always thought of joining ISER to for your further education? Sir, and we can start with you.
Okay, so like as you asked me, when I finished my school, so at that time it was not very clear where should I really go about. So after 12th class, I had given this National Defence Academy exam, and that time I cleared that exam as well. But my that time my goal was to explore myself a little bit more, and I went to Kota to study mathematics and study IIT to crack the IIT JEE exams. So at that place, I after like 1 year of my studying in Kota, I cleared JEE exam with some 7,000. I don't really clearly remember 6,000, 7,000 rank. So there I was. I got to know that I was not getting very good IITs at that particular point of time, and the branch was also not very good. But yes, there were three options that I had at that particular time, which was one is RJIPT, which I'm sure we all are aware of. The second one is ISER, and third is marine engineering. So I decided to join ISER as it was basically I had interest in mathematics, so I wanted to study mathematics and wanted to learn a bit more about it. But yes, during my school days, I had no idea about ISERs and any of the institutes which were any of working in science field. But this is how I ended up in ISO Bhopal.
Thank you, sir. What about you, ma'am?
Actually, in my school days, I have not thought of joining ISER for my just graduations and post graduations. But it was ISER was always in my bucket list because I was preparing for JEE Advanced, and I got a decent rank also in JEE Advanced. But then I saw that this ISER Bhopal, we can do research in some streams like chemistry and mathematics. So both of these branches really attracted me towards ISER Bhopal. So that's how I went. I came to ISER. I have joined ISER.
One thing I like to add here, sir, like when I joined ISER Bhopal, so at that time we were the pioneer batch of the institute. So we only had like an college of one room institute. I still remember that day. when my father came along with me and Dr. Vinod, who was the director of the ISRO Bhopal that time. So he welcomed us in that there was only one office. So we were all surprised. And now the thing is like from that state to the state that we have as of now has really improved and changed a lot. So I really feel very blessed to study in ISRO Bhopal, though I was not aware about it at that particular time. Some of my fellows basically guided me, some of my seniors guided me, and I ended up here. But it was a great turnaround.
That's really great to hear, especially considering most of us are currently studying in ISR. So another question which is sort of common to
Sakshi,
both of you is
Sakshi, if I may suggest something, if it's okay, you and Ria and Abhay can turn on your videos just so that since you're recording it'll be more of a lively interaction, if that is okay.
Yes, sir, sure, we'll do that.
The rest of us can keep it off for internet purposes, right?
Okay, I guess this is fine. Next question is also, yes, you are. Ma'am's also visible. So the next question is also so for both of you all. Considering that there are 5 varied natural sciences taught in ISR Bhopal, how did you make a decision towards the particular major you eventually went on to pursue, right? Chemistry in ma'am's case and mathematics in yours. Was it a best option among the 5, or was it a genuine interest-based choice?
So like as I've already told, I had really keen interest in studying mathematics. So during plus two also, and after that, the first 2 years that we have studied, is first 3 years that we had studied, we had studied all the subjects. So after the third year, it was very clear in my mind that I will choose mathematics. It was pure interest based. It was not like all the other 4 and other 5 subjects were equally good. But yes, it was purely an interest based choice.
So when I have joined ISR, I was not, as I told you that I was interested in maths and chemistry both. But in first 2 years, the chemistry has attracted my interest in it. And the credit goes to mainly to the professors. So that's why I just chose chemistry. And also I have just seen the job in which I can just pursue my career. So that's why I have taken chemistry as a suitable option for.
Okay, thank you. So we know that it was a very interest-based choice. So now moving on to more about your career. So what were the skills that you had to acquire, apart from academics, obviously? What are the skills you have to acquire during your college years to land the job which you're currently in?
Okay, so as I've told you, I'm serving in Indian Air Force. So here, what we really need is academically, if I say, so academically, it was not very much helpful. Yes, because the academic, the scenario has completely changed. What I've studied in ISR and what I am doing currently. And that scenario has completely changed. But yes, non-academically, I can say I have developed myself a lot during my ISR days, especially every other day, the classes that we used to had, the lectures that we used to conduct during my training days. So it helps me develop my self-personality, my communication skills, and the confidence that I can deliver speech whenever I'm asked to, and the situation reactions, the reaction time, because the field that I am, which is very demanding, and it requires that I have to react to situations very fast. So I had my professors with me. They guided me pretty well during the course of the time. And I think that those were the main skills during the academics, which helped me going this particular field. So with the help of these kind of traits, I can say that I could crack that SSB.
So basically, what I am doing in that, we have to work in a group, right? In ONGC, I am in procurement department for the installation, for the procurement of the installations that are in the offshore. So in that, we need to work in a group. So mainly the communication skills, interpersonality skills that our professor really helped us in our college days that in order to develop that. So mainly that and also the decision making skills. And also I need the management skills also because my job is related more to the management. So apart from academics, we required a lot of interpersonal skills, communication skills.
So if I may ask a question to both of you. So you said that besides your academics, you had you needed to develop many other skills, right? So I was wondering that did your stay at ICER in any way contribute to your development of such skills besides academic skills?
Yeah, sure, sir. That's true. Okay. That's completely true.
That's true, sir.
Okay.
Because
okay.
the presentations that we are giving in our in BSc and MSc that helps a lot because in my where I'm working right now, I have to give a lots of presentations, writing presentations, and we have to attend lots of conferences and all. So that's really helped for us.
Okay, that's very good to know. That's very good to know. Yeah, yeah. Very happy to hear that. Yeah, I'll let Sakshi carry.
Thank you, sir. So the next question I was specifically for ma'am. Was it always your intention to get a corporate job, like you're currently working in ONGC, or why did you not opt for more of a research or academia job that several of your peers must have done? Like, what was the reason for you to opt for a corporate job?
Actually, I have till my fifth year, I have not decided that whether I have to go for a corporate job or whether I have to do a research. I was trying for both. Like I have given a GATE exam and also I have given a TOEFL exam also for the research. I was interested in research, but when I saw the ONGC profile, ONGC is really very good, very good place where also you can pursue your, especially in chemistry, I'm talking about where you can perceive your research interest also. Like there are lots of lab where you can have the research on oil and gas products, right? And there are several research institutes in ONGC itself. And also the ONGC provides an opportunity after certain period of service that you can pursue your higher degree like PhD. And it will be on the ONGC. It will the ONGC will sponsor everything, your PhD and all. So this really this provides me, then this let me decide that I have to go for this job. And if I'm interested in, if I will be interested in future in PhD, then I can carry out that. So that's.
Yes, thank you so much, ma'am. So now a question for Flight Lieutenant Abhay Singh Chandel. I think this question was in all of our minds. How come a math major chose such an extraordinary and unprecedented path such as the armed forces?
So yes, as I've told, when I was in 12th class, at that point of time also I was interested. I had given NDA exam. I cleared that exam, but that time I wanted to explore myself more. But as soon as I went to college and started studying mathematics, so after completion of my third year, I was not sure I should go in research. Though it was clear in my mind, yes, after 5 years, I have to get settled. I wanted to, get settled and work at some place. But the thing was, getting in the defense sector was not easy because of the competition that we had at that point of time, and still it is there. So I was not sure. So that point of time, I started preparing for CAT exam. My interest was always there to work in defense sector because my family has a little background of defense. So I always wanted to go there, but the thing was, I started preparing for this also. I started giving exam from third year onwards for CDS, for FCAT, and every point of time I used to clear the written examination, but could not go for SSB. So one final year, that was my fifth year starting, I don't remember exactly. So that point of time I went for this SSB examination, and it was a 5 year, five days, sorry. It was a 5 days exam and I cracked it, and I was really happy that I finally got into it. it was like one of the dream when I was in school to get into a defense sector for me also and for my family also. It was, so I was very cheerful after getting into it.
Oh, that's great. I think we're all very happy to see that you're pursuing your dream. Now, more of a general question for both of you. What have you, what do you have to say about the skill-based acumen in your workplace? Like, over the long run, does it really matter if somebody's from natural sciences or from engineering? Or does it eventually even out, like, from whatever education you have, when you go into the workplace, does it really matter if you're from a particular field or does it eventually even out?
So if I talk about my sector, defense services, initially, if you are new to this particular field in defense sector, so initially 2 years, 3 years, this really helps out. If you are a technical personnel, if someone is from technical branch, so he will be able to get absorbed very fast, because it's all technical based what we have in defense, all the machinery, all the aircraft, all the things that we have, all machinery and technically based. So initially, yes, it is helpful, but over the time, I've already served 6 years in defense. So over the time, it is not, it actually boils down to the same level. I'm in the operational branch, but at times I'm tasked to do some technical jobs also. So yes, I'll say that initially it is helpful. But over the time, after 4, 5 years, 6 years, as you gain seniority in the defense sector, you started to learn each and everything about the sector, and then you can basically things are get boiled down to the same level.
Thank you, sir. Ma'am, what do you have to say about this?
In my point of view also, I think so in long run means it really do not matter whether you are from engineering background or from you're in science field, because I'm posted in a production where the chemical engineers and the mechanical engineers are being posted. So it really, because I have to learn that also, what they are doing, chemical engineers or mechanical engineers. So in my point of view, that at a first particular point, you have to learn the technical things also. So it really do not matter in long run whether you are where you are in science field or you are something in engineering something.
Thank you, ma'am. Now, ma'am, question for you, which is sort of a specific question. Though the trends, recent trends, indicate an increased percentage of women employed in the PSU, in PSU jobs, the standalone percentage compared to the percentage of men, it still remains low. What do you have to say regarding this with respect to your workplace, with regard to the percentage of women employed?
In recent years, I think so, women participation has increased. In ONGs especially, I can see now it's quite increasing, the women participation in PSUs, and also the women are taking more challenging jobs. Like previously, they are literally not posted at the offshore region and also not in the field. Now the women are posted at the offshore region also. So it's really, and even I have been to offshore for a couple of days. So it's really, it is really proud for me and as well as other girls that the ONGC and other PSUs are also providing us an opportunity to work where previously only men are allowed to do. So I think so their participations are increasing in PSUs, and it will further increase.
That is really good to hear, considering we're progressing so much. Sir, we had a question for you. How has all the knowledge that you have gained in ICER as a math major, and even the other non-academic skills you have gained, how have they helped you in your Air Force career so far?
As I've already mentioned a little bit about it, academic parts is not very, if I'm in defense in the operational field, so here the academic part is not very useful. The academics that I've learned major in mathematics and minor was physics. But yes, non-academically, that things that I've learned, especially while I was giving my examinations for SSB, for the written exam for FCAT, so that time it was really helpful. And after joining Indian Air Force, after joining the defense sector. So at, after there, I have realized that these things are more important. What we have it is my personal experience. The things that I've learned academically did not help me too much as I've learned non-academically, especially the lecture that I used to conduct for or seminar that I used to conduct for mathematics, the everyday interaction that I had with professors. So there, the development as a personality development or the communication skills that have improved, that had helped me a lot during my Air Force career so far. In the last 7 years, and the job itself demands such kind of activity. It demands that you are like every other day or second day, I have to give presentations, I have to prepare, and it can come like at any point of time. I will be given very short time notice. I will be given only 4 or 5 minutes, and I have to come and give presentation, whatever is there. So that reaction time has reduced a lot because of the practice that I already had during my school day, college days.
Right. Thank you, sir. I think now it becomes very clear that apart from academics, non-academical skills are also very important in whatever field we choose to pursue. So ma'am, I would like to ask you a question. You're currently an executive officer chemist at ONGC. How does one become an executive officer, and what are your responsibilities? Like, how did you plan get the job, and what are your responsibilities as an executive officer?
Just executive officer is not, it's just any PSU. If you join any PSU at the graduated level A, then you are an executive officer, basically. So my job is where I'm posted right now in Mumbai, and there are certain offshore installation in Mumbai region, right? In the offshore installations are there. So mainly I'm in a procurement department where I used to procure the things that are needed to the smooth and smooth functioning of the operational installations at the offshore. So in that way, I help. Basically, I'm a material management. In short, if you say, I'm a material management officer, basically.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. Sir, this question is for you. What were some of the challenges that you faced during your transition from being a graduate student to joining the armed forces? And in what way has it changed you? In what way has the process changed you?
The most challenging thing that I've experienced after joining the defense services was, I think, the fitness part that we all lack during our college days. I don't know how the scenario has changed now, but during my college days, because at that time, still the institute was getting established, and there was no main campus at that point of time. So we did not have any good facilities for sports activities, and there were not too much of, focus on these part of things. However, these part of things, as I've joined defense sector, I've realized it is as equally as important as the academics are during the college days, because all the students, I'm not talking only about myself, I'm talking about the other students also who have joined, who have given CDS exam or FCAT exam and have joined Air Force, Army or Navy, whatever defense field it is. The main thing that they lack is fitness capability. Though I was doing the fitness things like gym and all these things, running on my own during my college day itself. But other students that which I have met or have seen, they have really struggled a lot. And I tell you what happens is, people come to defense services just after 1 month of training or 40 days of training, people just go back to their home or they just quit. Because of the main issue I'm just telling you is because of the fitness thing. The kind of fitness you require here is very demanding and challenging. So if we change or we start focusing on fitness part also during right from the college days, so I think it will be very helpful once a student get, if at all they want to go into defense services, they will feel it really beneficial, and they can get acquire and they can get absorbed here very easily. It will not be very hard to them, I'll say.
Thank you, sir. So like the last question from our side would be, how has this lockdown been for you? Like how have, has it been with respect to your careers and with respect to your jobs? Like have you still been working or working from home? So how has it been for you and your co-workers?
So like if I talk about myself, in defense sector, as of now, there is no notation called lockdown. We are still working in the same way that we were working. Only the thing is, we have started practicing the things that that has been issued by the government, like social distancing, wearing masks and all these things. But the work culture or the amount of work has not reduced or increased. It is still the same way that we were having at, before the lockdown. But yes, we are finding it a little difficult also, because initially, if I talk about the things that initially we were able to go out and do things, but because of the lockdown and the number of cases that we are having every day, going outside and doing stuff outside is not possible now. But yes, work-wise, things have not changed much. At times, there will be differences, like, but not be too much. What we do is we start making shifts, and then reduce the percentage of people who are coming and working at one particular station. So by doing that, the number of people are reduces, and then this ensure the safety of every personnel who are working under the sector.
Right. Thank you so much, sir. Now we'll move on to the questions, which some questions which the people have, people who are attending the meeting have asked. First question, I think it's for sir, is science background required for the armed forces? It's asked by Ishika.
No, I didn't get you. Please, can you please come again?
Do you always require a science background to join the armed forces?
No, it is not like that. Science background is not very compulsory thing. I think you have to be graduate enough. The graduation can be from any field. You can be engineer, you can do BA. The only thing is that I'm talking about, that is what I told. Academic part is not very beneficial in armed forces. The non-academic part is yes. You have to crack the SSB, you have to be very personally developed. Then only you can get through the SSB examination. But yes, science background is not compulsory, but it eventually helps you if you are from science background, because you get absorbed in the situations and the current scenarios very easily. Because if you are not from science background, then developments, all the science things that, or all the technologies that we are discussing here in the defense sector will not be very fruitful to them. But yes, more or less, it is not very beneficial, but it helps.
Thank you, sir. I hope the question is answered. The next question is from Shashank. It's for Ria ma'am. He's asking, what is the future of ONGC when electric and other forms of cleaner energy are gaining more demand? How is the company changing itself to compete in the upcoming time?
Of course, the ONGC every time there will be a need of oil and gas, okay? But the ONGC are also going for the alternate source of energy, like solar energy, wind energy. And if you see the ONGC websites and all, if you go through that, the ONGC has a really very large plant of solar energy in Gujarat side, in Cambay side, basically. So it's good. And also the wind energy in different parts of Jharkhand and all. So ONGC is literally changing and it's going for the alternate source of energy also.
Thank you, ma'am. Next question is by Prakash Chandra Tiwari. His question is also for ma'am. He's asking, as we all have to do our MS project in the fifth year, and in chemistry, there is a lot of lab work involved. And he's also mentioned that you got a GATE rank of 4. How did you manage both lab work as well as preparing for the GATE exam simultaneously?
Basically, it's just a time management, how you manage your work and how you focus on your lab work as well as on your studies. So it's just a time management, and I don't think so anything. To crack a GATE exam, we have to do different things. Like, it is just our coursework only. And if we are more focused on our lectures, and if we follow basic books that we were taught in the BSM and MS, so it will be easily you can crack the GATE exam. And just it requires time management to work in the lab as well as to get a good score in GATE.
Thank you, ma'am. I hope the question is answered. The next question is by Harsha. It's for sir. How was it to be a part of the first graduating batch of ISER Bhopal? What made you join an institute which was just getting established when you weren't really aware of ISERs then? And how confident were you about your choice back then?
Yeah. So when I joined ISER Bhopal, my batch was a pioneer batch, but ISERs were already established. I think at that time, Kolkata one and Pune one were already functional. So I have spoken to the faculties and students of ISER Kolkata and Pune. And as I've told, I had interest in mathematics and the choices that I had that particular time. This is the most beneficial one and the one that interests me a lot at that particular time. However, as I knew that the college is going to have to take a time to establish because it was just a pioneer batch, and that particular time we did not had our own campus. At that time, we were working in transit campus. Kashyap sir knows it very well. We had all our classes there at transit campus. So
I would like to add to that. I mean, that was a very difficult place to work with. I remember that the first time we shifted, and you guys stayed there till 2013, right? You never moved into the main campus.
No, never, sir. Last year, I think few classes, I think four or five lectures we had in our new campus. So we have to travel a lot.
You guys had to take the bus all the way from ITI to Bauri just to attend a class.
We were the batch who suffered a lot, but yes, we have gained a lot also because we were the one who were establishing the institute at that point of time. We were the 18 Mavens that we used to call us at that point of time.
Let me make an honest confession, but I know you guys went through a lot of difficulty, but you are our favorite batch. Other batches that was present there. And I think many, many professors there will also agree with that. And we were really fond of you guys. And we were really proud that,
Even today, sir, when I speak to any of my friends, like you remember the Chirag, sir, he was a math graduate.
Of course.
Chirag, Mandeep, Kostu, we all still, remember, sir, each and every professor. Because we were only 18. And then every professor had individual focus on each and every individual.
Absolutely.
What you are doing, tomorrow is your lecture. So every day we used to give some or other lecture to some other professor.
That is correct. And also I remember that I was really inexperienced when I joined. Yeah, I joined in 2011 and you guys were 3 years into your program.
Yes, sir.
So for me also, it was a completely new experience, just like you. And the same question that she just asked you probably applied to me also. Why did I join this?
We used to have classes.
I remember the math department. The math department had five members at that time.
My batch sir had three members, sir. Me, Chirag, and Mahesh.
Your batch had just three members.
The junior one, two, sir. I think two.
Despite the difficult times, I think they were really enjoyable times for all of us.
I do
cherish all those memories. Definitely.
Yes, sir. I also still do, sir. It was really
Let Sakshi carry on.
Yes, sir. So the next question is also for you, sir. What guidance would you give, would you wish to impart to somebody who wants to crack the SSB after CDS or NDA?
Okay, I'll say that first of all, if you are really interested in defense or anyone, so he has to be really devoted enough. Like he has to work on not only the academic parts, non-academic parts are more important, and then fitness part also. Otherwise, as I've told you, many people come and go a 1 month training or 40 days of training, and they leave because of the difficulties that they face during the training part. I tell you, it is very difficult. So my guidance will be that. Focus on whatever your professor is saying. Eventually, all these things are boiled down to the same level, your personality development. You are going to yourself develop a lot during your academics and non-academics things. And as I've already said, I don't know what is the scenario as of now, but if we can impart more and more sports facility in institutes, like if we can arrange some marathon runs or some sports like kickboxing, kind of that, those stuff, where our endurance, our strength increases, So that will eventually help you in cracking SSB. Because SSB is not only about your, I tell you, it's not only about your personality development. It's also about fitness also. So there you will be checked for each and everything for 5 days. And then after 5 days, you are going to get selected for that. And the percentage ratio, I tell you, is very less. So please, whenever you are going for any SSB or if you are preparing for defense services, make sure that you are getting guidance from your professors and follow the instructions that they are giving to you, and eventually you are going to get through it. And additionally, you have to work yourself on your fitness.
I think there are some really great words, and I hope all of us have really imbibed those. Ma'am, this question is for you related to exams. In which year of BSMS are we eligible to appear for GATE?
I think so, in fifth year only we are eligible for GATE, because this PSU literally wants the same year GATE score. So it will be when we are in fifth year, then only that's the best time to give GATE, the last year of the graduation.
Okay, ma'am, and if I would like to, I'd like to add over here, how did you prepare for the CSIR exams? Can you also elaborate a little bit on that? You answered about GATE, now we'd like to know about CSIR.
CSIR exam also, I have not taken any coaching or something. I've just focused on my basic concept, like whatever our professor, I want to thank our chemistry professor, Abhijit Patra sir, Manmohan sir, or Jay Shankar sir, Saptarishi sir. Means I literally want to thank them, because their way of teaching literally helped us. And also I just want to, in this point of view, I just want to just give a suggestion to people who are in fifth year, not in fifth year, in third year or fourth year, people should choose their, because we are taking some, there are compulsory courses and some electives we are taking now. So they should choose their course wisely if they are giving these exams, because some of them choose courses like ki isme score acha ho jayega hamara, so isliye hum log ye course choose kar rahe hain. But they should choose accordingly, like which course, agar theek hai, agar usme aap kar bhi nahi pa rahe ho, matlab okay, but at least they can, these courses can help you in the exam for clearing out the exams. So I think so that the people should think about taking their choices for the
post. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Yeah, just 1 minute, Sakshi. I would like to add here. And thank you, Ria, for taking up this question. And please, can you please also suggest one thing, like as for example, you joined for a PSU job, and for that purpose, perhaps your CSIR rank or CSIR exam qualifications, all these things probably not that much needed also. But still you could crack that one, and I believe that that's a very good point in your CV. And I want to be very honest, when I was asked that we need to choose one of our alumni from chemistry, I looked at your credentials, and that's gave me an automatic choice that probably your experience would help to our current batch of students. So can you also say something to our students, like let's say if you have a plan for a corporate job, not probably pursuing PhD, but still probably these exams are very important, right? That will also help you in your CV and all the way. What do you think?
Mainly GATE is very helpful in getting one of the PSU or corporate job. Like if you are focused on your basic coursework in BS also and also in MS. So if you take a particular course, like in chemistry, I will talk about like mainly I have when I was in my third year and fourth year, my batchmates used to be scared from organic chemistry, and they are more focused on inorganic chemistry. So I think so for cracking these exams, I think so all the courses, physical, organic, quantum, and all the courses literally has a meaning, like they all have certain they have certain importance in that, and sabka apna apna ek wo hota hai ki itna scoring part hai, to I think so sare subjects hame lene chahiye. एंड और हम लोगों को मतलब उस पे अगर हम बेसिक हमारे जो बेसिक बुक्स हैं द पीपल गो फॉर कोचिंग्स प्रिपेयरिंग दिस एग्जाम्स थ्रू कोचिंग्स बट आई थिंक सो इन माय पर्सपेक्टिव आई हैव नेवर जॉइंड अ कोचिंग फॉर दिस क्रैकिंग सच एग्जाम्स नॉर आई हैव टेकन एनी सोर्स एनी कॉरेस्पॉन्डेंस कोर्स फ्रॉम अदर कोचिंग क्लासेस सो आई जस्ट फोकस्ड ऑन द बुक दैट अवर प्रोफेसर प्रिफर्स बेसिकली that if we will read that book and clear our concept, that will literally help us in cracking all exams.
Thank you. Sakshi, you may continue. And there are also certain questions posted in the chat box. You may also check that.
Yes, sir. We are doing those. So this is a question for you. How can we contribute in a more technical role in terms of DRDO, HAL, ADA and ADA so that we are a part of the defense sector indigenization?
I want to ask, this is after joining the Air Force or before that? If you want to be a part of it.
Can you clarify, Harsh Bharatwaj, can you clarify?
Both scenarios will be different.
Both scenarios? Yes, sir.
Okay. I'll first talk about after getting into Air Force. These are all at DRDO sector, HAL sector. These are all interconnected to all defense services, Army, Air Force, Navy. So if I talk about getting into Air Force, then after the participation into this, the chances are very minimalistic because you yourself are working in this particular field. So you are not able to, you will not be able to get too much of time and get into these different fields like DRDO or HAL. But yes, if you want to participate in these fields, these are all are equally as challenging and defense related fields only. Then you have to go through a different channel. After getting into Air Force, we do not have too much of interaction with DRDO personnels at junior level, I'll say, at junior level or HAL personnel. But yes, after getting senior, like after SCON leaders, after becoming SCON leader or wing commander, then yes, everything, we started having interaction with these all DRDO personnel and HAL personnel. We also start having classes together and we go there as a part of trainees. The people from DRDO and HAL come in Air Force as also a part of trainee or course instructor. So we eventually learn from them and they also learn from them. So it is basically all interdependent. If you join Air Force, but that happens only after you getting a senior. During the junior level, there is no interaction till about you are flight level or something. After getting senior SCON leader wing commander, you start having interaction, having lots of classes and career oriented opportunities which you have in HAL and DRDOs, and people eventually get absorbed also as part of Air Force also, be it as an instructor. Or as a part of like director or something in DRDO or HAL. So we have staff who is working there and is working in defense sector, working in Indian Air Force or Army or Navy previously.
Thank you so much, sir. I hope your question is clear. I hope you're clarifying. Next question is for ma'am. Saksham is asking, how did you prepare for ONGC?
The same. No, I have cleared the GATE exam and the. So through GATE only the ONGC is taking recruitment. So just clear the GATE exam and then applied for it.
Ma'am. Okay, somebody is asking what is the status of ONGC recruitment in 2021.
This I also cannot say because our offices are not working properly now. So. How could I say about the new recruitment in 2021?
Right. So I think that's a question for the HR. One more question is for ma'am. How much time do you dedicate towards the preparation of the GATE exam? I think this question is more about how you managed your time while preparation, apart from lab work and other academic related stuff.
See, what I used to do is that I just we need time for GATE. It's not an easy exam. Like we need time and we need lot of practice also. Practicing means previous year paper, you can practice previous year papers, and also means when you have lab work, you can just manage, you can just do complete your lab work till 7 o'clock. Yeah, I used to be in lab till 7 o'clock, and then after that you can just there is a night, and then you can have a night study, and also at least around 5-6 hours daily you need for the, I think, for preparation for the GATE. It isn't my point of view. I don't know. It depend. It differ from person to person. So it literally requires a lot of practice. Means previous year's papers and speed also it required in GATE. So it requires a lot of practice. So you have to manage your time between your lab and so this is the fifth year is literally hectic for me also. So but yeah, I managed to do that. So I think so others can also do.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Okay, the next question is again for you. It says the campus must have changed a lot during your time at ICER. So how was the whole transition process of the campus while you were studying here?
So when I have joined in 2013. So at that time we were in a new campus only, but our like physics labs and biology labs were in ITI. So in so we have to for the labs we have to travel a lot to go there, and only chemistry labs were there in this main campus. And the whole this whole campus was under construction. So sometimes there were no road. I think so there were a few roads only, and there were no roads also. And in the rainy season, it's really a very difficult job to go from LHC to our even hostel, that we don't have roads also. So that's why.
So Ria, if I may add, even the faculty were housed at the chemistry building.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
There was no academic building one at that time.
Yes.
So I remember I had an office in academic building two, which was a chemistry block.
PhD
yeah.
Boys, even PhD boys were there in girls' hostel also. So there was just mixed up things were there. And
Yeah. It was not easy. Yeah, I remember that.
It was not easy. But that was also a good time, sir. And now I have ISIS pictures, the people are posting ISIS pictures, and ISIS has changed really a lot.
Yeah. I hope you can visit us in the near future, both of you.
Yeah,
it will be a pleasure to host both of you in ISIS. So do consider visiting us whenever, you know, the COVID situation eases out. I would request an appeal to both of you to visit us, you know.
Definitely, sir. I'll visit, sir.
Yeah. Thank you for that. Yeah.
Thank you, sir. Okay. The next question is for Abhay, sir. The question says, what motivates you to stay away from your family and work for the country year long with less holidays?
Oh, yes. So I think the main motivation behind it, I think, was serving for the country. As I told you, it was my always interest to do. I think it is not the case only for me. Most of the people who are working in MNC or some other field, they are staying away from the family only for most of the time. But yes, for us people, it is more difficult and more challenging because we have to go to a very high terrain fields also. Like I've been to Kargil, Leh, and all the forward Siachen glaciers and all the, I've stayed there also. So yes, if you have these kind of parts, yes, it is very difficult. But the motivations, I think, is come from basically from the factor that it was the very first thing that I always wanted to do. And when I get into here, so whatever it demands, I will always be up for it. So that is actually the main motivation factor.
Right, thank you, sir. I think we're all really, really proud to have somebody who is a graduate from ISOR serving our country. Ma'am, this next question is for you. What are the other ways in which you can get into ONGC other than GATE, considering chemical engineering graduates from our college? So our college has a BS chemical engineering degree as well. So are they also eligible?
Chemical engineering degree is eligible. Chemical engineering people get through chemical engineering also. So, but you have to give GATE exam, and in some of the institute they take by the placement also. So, if ISA can literally approach ONGC for do the campus placement, then it will be a great thing. Else, the option is only the GATE exam.
Okay, I think that clarifies the question. Next question is also for sir. It says, as you had said that you had to clear the NDA, you had cleared the NDA exam, then you could have. Just 1 second.
Maybe I didn't get you.
So the question says that what you had already cleared. I'll repeat it. You had already cleared the NDA exam before you joined ICER. So the question says, what was the spark that led you to first fulfill your interest in math and then go for the armed forces? Also, there's another question. Did you give both AFCAT and CDSE? And which,
okay, yes. I have given NDA exam previous when I was in college, when I was in school. So I cleared that exam at that point of time, but my main focus was at that time was mainly to learn more and more and to explore myself more, because it was in very early stage to get into defense services. I'll tell you that if you get into NDA right from school level, you get very less time outside most of the time, because after that 4 years you get yourself jam packed in defense academy. You are not able to go out, see things like that. They're not able to explore. So it's the best way to join defense services after college. So that point where you have explored things outside also, or now you are mature enough to take your decisions. Because at school days, those days were very early for me. I was not very sure that I should go in defense, though I cleared the exam. So I wanted to explore myself more. But yes, after getting into college, after completion of my third year, so I wanted to go in defense sector, to be very practical, the selection rate was very less. So I started preparing for CAT also. I started preparing for CAT. I remember the institute name. It was Time Institute. It was there in MP Nagar. MP Nagar. It was the Time Institute was in MP Nagar. So from 8th semester I started preparing for CAT exam. So with the preparation of CAT and the things that I've learned from ICER Bhopal faculties, I started giving exams of NDA, FCAT and CDS. And every time I cracked the written examination, the first chance that I've got, the first chance was I think in the fifth year, and I went for SSB examination. So that was the first time I cracked it. And I think my percentile for CAT also was at that year was 96. But after getting into defense services, all things were second, and eventually went into advanced field.
It states that can a maths or physics graduate get a job in PSU if they have a good GATE score? What are the opportunities for data science graduates in PSU?
I don't know about maths, but the physics graduates can apply for PS like in the field of geophysicals. In geophysicists, there is a stream called geophysicist. In that geophysicist, you can apply for physics graduates can apply.
And what about data science graduates in?
Data science graduates can apply, I think, so in programming. There's another stream called programming and some, I don't remember exactly, but it is related to programming. So in that stream, the data science graduates can apply. I'm especially talking about ONGC, okay.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you. Sir, someone has asked, the content we get at ISOR is a lot. Then how did you manage to prepare for AFCAT and CDS at the same time? And did you start to prepare from your third year?
Yes, so as I told you, it is all about time management. Right from fourth year onwards, the very first thing which was clear in my mind was I'm not going to go in the research field. Either I'll go to I'll change. I was focused to change my field. I was either go to defense sector if at all I get through the chance, as I told you, because of the probability was way less, or I'll go to an MBA sector and start studying finance, the field which was I was more interested in. So the fourth year onwards, I started giving examination online. There's online portal also where we can give online examination for CAFCAT and CDS. And I started solving previous year question papers. Apart from this, I used to go for CAT preparation. So there I've also learned a lot during the time institute. And in the evening, I had classes in the morning and in the evening. So afternoon period that I used to get. So that afternoon slot of 3 to 4 hours was mainly focused on this particular thing only. So the 2 hours class I used to have in time institute, and the rest 1 hour I used to work on myself for the fitness thing. I used to run and go to gym outside. So that basically it's all time management. So the fourth year students, if they are here online. So fourth year and fifth year is very important if you at all are planning to go in any of the field. So these 2 years are really important because these are the times when you have to spend most of the time working on yourself. Spending time, basically, you have to first decide the way you have to go, and then basically channelize the things according to the way, such that it all lands up there. So channelization and time management, right, is very important right from fourth year onwards. And eventually it will happen if you are really motivated enough, you motivate yourself. You see people, how they are working outside in that particular sector, if you at all want to go there. So you start talking to them, they will tell you how good it is, how bad it is. So if you are motivated enough, you have to work right from the fourth year onwards. Otherwise, I tell you, fifth year will be a little late and you will have to mug up too much of things in that particular. Because most of the things get finished in fifth year, and eventually after, if you get after fifth year, I tell you, my graduation finished in the month of March, and I joined Air Force in the month of June. So hardly there was a gap of 2 months only, and I joined Air Force. So it was because only I have started working from fourth year onwards.
Thank you, sir. So the next question is a little lighter, and it's for both of y'all. Soumya is asking, what are your best memories and moments from your time at ISOR Bhopal?
My best memories are the DJ nights that are organized during Inducia. I enjoyed a lot that thing, and we were the people who used to leave at the last, and then also we are just shouting that once more. So that is the, and also the late night walks, because the ISA campus was a very nice campus, so that I loved it, and I still remember that.
Well, if I tell about myself.
Sir, what about you?
I had really a lot of memories in ISRs, because I tell you, when I joined ISR, there was nothing outside there. There was no campus. We used to live in ITI hostels. So we had some little area. We used to play there. We used to play cricket. The 18 students that we had, we are all very, small knit community kind of thing. Because, as I told you, it was my first batch. So we never had any cultural fest. There was nothing like that. So we went to Pune. We had to learn from our seniors, okay, this is the way a cultural fest is organized. Because there was a first fest that we have seen. I think the name, I don't remember what was the Pune's name. Karwa or something. And it was something Karwa or something in the Pune. So then the Enthusia name was given by us only. And the second year, we organized Enthusia. And it was us only, we did not have any sponsors at that point of time. We have to spend money from our pockets also to get things done at that point of time. So it was really, but we wanted it to be a big fest. We had called students from outside also. Not only this, we had organized, we have called DJ or something like this, very renowned people we have called. And considering that the small federation that we had at that particular time, it was really a big thing. And it was the one of the most memorable thing, the first enthusiasm that we had. and the success that it had achieved after slowly in the progressive years, it is really good. And I have seen the video of ISR Bhopal now, ISR campus. I think it is available in YouTube. I was really mesmerized by seeing the videos of ISR Bhopal, that way it has changed. We were the people who actually laid the foundation of ISR Bhopal at that point of time. So the things have changed completely. And I'm really happy that ISR Bhopal is gaining heights and heights with every passing day. And yeah, memories are always the good memories. I'm going to cherish them into my whole lifetime.
Thank you so much, ma'am and sir. I think we all really liked listening to that. And I think we can mostly relate to what ma'am said, considering even we have DJ night, occasionally have DJ nights. Okay, the last question the second last question is for sir. It says, how can we join institutions like ISRO, DRDO, and ADA after graduating from ISRO Bhopal?
Institutions like?
ISRO, DRDO, and ADA.
Okay, ISRO, I tell you, for ISRO, there's a different examination conducted. If I talk about defense sector, you can visit the website careerairforce.nic.in. It is for everyone who's listening here. This particular website gives you the details about your eligibility criteria, like what are the basic courses required that you have to undergo for different branches. You can go there. But these only tell you about defense, like for Air Force. If you want to go for Navy and Army, then you have to go for UPSC. But this ISRO, all together different channel is there. And DRDO, as of now, I'm not sure how to go through it, because though I think it is also conducting a different level examination. But from defense sector, like from UPSC or from from FCAT, it is not possible. But yes, I'm sure there will be an examination for DRDO also. I'm not very sure what exam do we call it. Though we keep on having the interaction with the DRDO people and not ISRO, but DRDO and HAL people. But I'm not sure which exams they have given, especially the DRDO people. But yes. These are the websites you can note down, careerinfos.nic.in or upsc.gov.in, where you can find all the details of the examinations or the exam related pattern, or we can say the syllabus that is required to study to crack this examination.
Sakshi, I have to add in this, the DRDO, in the research point of view, if you want to go into DRDO, basically DRDO is also taking through GATE, but it's occasionally for the scientist B position. So if some people have a good rank in GATE, but they are taking the top rankers. So some people have a good rank and they are interested in research, then they can apply through GATE exam in the DRDO.
Yeah, rightly he has said, but from defense channel it is not.
Okay, thank you so much. Okay, the last question is for sir. It states that as we all are concerned, there are many critical places where people from the armed forces have to stay, like the desert, the mountains, the Siachen Glacier, etc. So is there any post in the defense sector that is offered directly to a geologist or some environmental scientist?
Is there, I didn't get the last part. Is there any?
So are there any jobs in the defense sector that are offered directly to geologists or environmental scientists?
From defense sector it is not possible, but yes, those are specific fields and different departments, they are working all together differently. If you go to mountains, you will see different centers out there working on these particular fields, but from defense sector it is not possible. From defense you will be entirely working on the operational field which requires to be, you know, safeguard the country's boundary, to safeguard the skies. You will not be working as a geologist. You will be entirely into operational branch, operation kind of things. Those are entirely a different sector of field.
Okay, sir, thank you. So that concludes our question answer session. And I would like to thank both of you all for taking out time from your very busy schedules to come and talk to us and inspire us basically and tell us more about your career and about your line of work. And considering that you all are from the same college that we are currently studying in, it really, we can relate more to it. And we wish you best of luck in your future endeavors. Is Patra sir here? Would he like to say something?
Yeah, so thank you Abhay, and it's a great time to listen to you and Ria also. So
My
it's
dear,
a great pleasure for us and our students, and we'll be in touch with you. And I would also like to thank our office, Arshi, and particularly Arshi and also Mr. Rath, who helped us to organize this one. I think RC has communicated with you multiple times to both of you, and he will again be in touch with you for other information, like Ria said, some campus placement by ONGC. So RC will be in touch with you, and if you can lead, give us some lead to, so that we can bring those companies in the campus, it will be a great help for the current students. And we are going to make an alumni association for ISR Bhopal. So it is there for some of the ISRs. We are going to organize that one. So very soon we'll have a online alumni meet. Definitely we would like your presence, particularly all your first batch of students' presence. And some of you can be our alumni ambassadors, so that we can make this alumni association of ISR Bhopal. It's like an independent organization which can make a network between the current students and our alumni. So once again, I would like to thank both of you, and we wish that one day that situations will be normalized very soon, hopefully. And, please visit us. It will be a great pleasure to have you in the campus, in this campus. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. And thank you everybody for attending this session. And we'll sign off here. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, and all the students who has so much of patience in listening to me and having this conversation and having me out here to share my experiences and all. So it was really a good experience talking to and interacting with you all guys. I hope we'll be in touch in the future also, and keep on sharing new thoughts that ISRs will be having and what are the changes that they are going to have. So it was really a good thing, and thank you so much, especially Arshi sir, who has basically managed all these things. Thank you so much, sir.
I'd like
you.
To thank Patra sir. Thank you, Patra sir, and the organizers
thank you.
This webinar. And this is really a very good opportunity to again talk to, interact with ICERITES. So looking forward for more such opportunities. So thank you.
Thank you very much. I thank also SDC. SDC Sakshi, Dhawal, to coordinate that one, and also RC. Thank you all. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you for being here.
See you. All the very best.
Thank you, everyone.